As the parliamentary committees of health and trade continue to jointly scrutinize the Alcoholic Drinks Control Bill 2023, today they interfaced with artists under the National Culture Forum, who registered their strong reservations on the bill, as Charles Sabatambuze, the vice chairperson of NCF, submits. Artists, led by Daniel Kazibwe alias Raggedy, rejected the clause in the bill which proposes time limit to sale of alcohol, saying it's dangerous to the night economy on which the entertainment industry thrives.
Restricting the hours of work will reduce royalties to musicians and all artists and kill investments in the creative industries.
This bill should be talking about enforcement. It should be talking about not the business. For us, we're talking about the business, because we know the money that comes to pay the MPs in parliament comes from the night economy. The biggest taxpayers are the breweries. The breweries bring the money that comes here. But the secondary people that you're not talking about are who makes this money.
In clause 14 of the bill, Sarah Opendi, the mover of the bill, proposes to regulate the time within which alcoholic drinks are sold in Uganda by limiting it to only 5 hours during weekdays and 12 hours during weekends. The bill proposes a fine of 20 million shillings or imprisonment for a period of 10 years or both for those convicted for selling alcohol beyond 10 p.m.
In Africa, Uganda is the leading consumer of alcohol. We consume 12.21 liters per year, so we are the first in Africa. And we are the fifth globally in the whole world in terms of alcohol consumption. So I would have wanted to know, in light of your proposal to reject the bill, which you'll also confirm, whether you feel that also these figures, these statistics we're talking about, really are statistics that you would be proud to talk about.
One of the beneficiaries who had made a name from Facebook, but Facebook is closed and you cannot market your products from there. So we are working in bars, which bars are expected to be closing at around 10 p.m. It is affecting a lot of people because we don't have any other business currently. We don't have gardens we can turn to. We don't have shops we can turn to.
When we hold a show, say a music concert, we 1.5 billion shillings is transferred that in one night. Imagine the shows or the trillions that you'll be stifling or killing if you bring this law. So we are politely praying that the laws that are in place, from the penal code, from the constitution, from every bit, help us to control this alcohol. So what are we saying?
Artists argued that the Alcohol Drinks Control Bill 2023 is nugatory in a country riddled with serious human capital problems, and asked Parliament to reject it.
We always perform in different places of the country, but the alcohol which affects the people's brains and it's making them go crazy, they are the cheapest products. That means there is a problem with UNBS.
I have seen many of you, not you as the celebrities, but many Ugandans going into herbs, Butavika, ending up in such states. How have you curbed this to help our colleagues?
They also registered fears with the proposal to regulate advertisement of alcoholic drinks, saying the law threatens artists whose works may be misinterpreted as deceptive.
This section poses a threat to the use of alcohol as the subject of expression of art.
Their submissions were reinforced by the Private Sector Foundation of Uganda, which told the committee that alcohol is a source of employment for over 1.3 million Ugandans who are threatened by the law. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.